Trey Flowers. And a timeout is immediately taken by New England. Well, Trey Flowers, he goes right through Alex Mack, and this is what Matt Ryan just couldn't afford to do. Once he starts to scramble, you just can't take the sack there. It doesn't knock him out in terms of being in field goal range, but that's a costly sack by Matt Ryan.
It would be a 53-yard field goal from this spot. Matt Ryan has plenty of leg for that, but that sack makes the field goal try just that much more difficult if the Falcons don't come up with any yardage on this 3rd and 23.
Yeah, and Matt Ryan's got to be smart here. Can't afford another sack. Try to pick up some yards. Make it easier for Matt Ryan. 3 points is big right now in this ballgame.
Elijah Twelve on that sack. Passes caught Sanu. And that's exactly what happened. A flag is down back in the area where Matt Ryan went down, and we'll check the call.
Holding, number 70 offense. Replay third down.
That's Jake Matthews, the third year, first round pick out of Texas A&M, guilty of this hold on Chris Long. And that is a massive call against Atlanta. And then on the back end of it, on the tackle of Sanu, they may have missed a face mask. Really both ways on Sanu and Logan Ryan. The ball's back at the 45, and they are out of field goal range after the hold by Matthews.
Well, we'll see what Bill Belichick elects to do here, because Matt Ryan's got the same approach. Now you're just trying to get yards, get back in field goal range, and give yourself a chance.
How long for the ride, won't you? Austin Hooper, the rookie tight end, with a touchdown that made it 14-0. This, the 82-yard interception and return by Robert Alford, made it 21-0 in that 10th opponent. This was all Atlanta. The last time the Patriots had it, a touchdown by Danny Amendola from Brady. James White punched in a 2-point conversion. It's a 1-score game with a touchdown and a successful 2-point try. And look at the NFL postseason, not Super Bowl history.